Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genci. In the last videos, we talked about wall, ceiling, and floor detail design based on SB-12 of Ontario Building Code. In this video, I'm gonna do more examples on walls. In some of the walls, as you see here, for nominal, we have one number plus one number CI. So I'm gonna talk about it. What is that CI? How does it affect the detail? So let's work on package A4. Of like zone one, let's say we are in Ontario, it's zone one, 95%. I'm working on package A4, right? So we're gonna have at least 3.77 for effective RSI and 3.87 plus 0.88 CI for nominal. Basically, that CI means continuous insulation, and that means in this case we have two sets of insulation. One set of insulation is between the studs of the wall, the other insulation is continuous, it's just next to that layer. So I'm gonna show you an example. If you go to an NRCan website, if you go to examples, you see one of the wall examples, such as example 7. Basically, we have extruded polystyrene, and this is continuous, right? You see it says continuous material, and it's above the stud lumber that we have for the wall. So basically, we have 2x6s, they are 16 inches apart, and the nominal, the RSI of the insulation of the cavity fill is 3.87, and it's going to add up to 3.88. So I'm going to show this here. So based on this, this is example 7 from NRCan. This is what we have. What we want is 3.77 for effective or higher. So if we go with 3.88, this totally makes sense. And you see for continuous, this is 0.88 CI, which is what we have here. And finally, for this part of the nominal, 3.87, we have 3.87. So both nominals are okay. Where do we get that 0.88? So here's how it works. Basically, for polystyrene, if you go to table CM1 of NRCan, the same website, you see that for 1 millimeter, we have 0.035. Okay, that's for 1 millimeter of polystyrene. So if we need 0.88, and if we divide it by 0.035, that's going to give us the amount of thickness of the insulation, which is 25. So that's why you see we have 25 millimeters. And in this case, because this is continuous, the amount of nominal and RSI for this specific layer would be the same, right? So this is our 0.88 CI. That's why you saw on the other side. And this all makes sense. We can go with this wall exactly. If you want to kind of make any changes, you cannot change the thickness of this layer because we need to hit a minimum of 0.88 for the continuous CI. And we're going to need 3.87 for nominal. So basically, you cannot change this insulation, which is for cavity fill either. The only thing that you might change if you need to is actually the distance between the studs, right? So let me show you how this works. If I go to here, I want to check my walls. I want to go all the way to the top, go to walls above and not in contact with ground. We have lumber studs. The wall I showed you, this is 2x6 inches, 3.87. Okay, so this is 2x4, table WA1. I need to go to WA2, which is 2x6s. For a nominal of 3.87, for every 16 inches, we have 2.55. In case, for some reason, if you need to put the studs every 12 inches, is it going to work in this case? So we can check that. If we go every 12 inches for 3.87, we cannot go lower. So that's our minimum nominal. That's going to be 2.49. So if I come here, change this to 2.49 for like a structural reasons or something, and then this is going to be every 12 inches. And it's the same thing. So this is 304, 2x6 is good. I can change this to 304. Does it work? Well, basically, yes, because this is now 3.82. This is still higher than 3.77. So if for some reason, for structural reasons, we need to make the studs closer to each other so it's going to be stronger, yes, we can do it and it's still going to provide the value. So continuous is the same, 3.87, that's the same, we didn't change it. The only thing we changed was the distance between the studs. That's why our effective is a bit lower, but still this value fits there. So I'm going to go with 3.82 in this case. A4, you can put 3.82. And for suggested nominal, this is 0.88 plus 3.87. 3.87 comes from there, 0.88 comes from there. So I'm gonna go with exactly this. So it's gonna meet the code for nominal and it's gonna exceed the code for effective. So these are actually just examples. If you go with package A1, all your wall, ceiling, floors should be selected from package A1. You cannot mix and match. But I'm just going through two examples to see how it works. Now, let's say I want to draw the detail for this from the interior side, which is this side. First, I have the gypsum board, it's 12.7. You remember I had an AutoCAD file before. I'm going to keep working on that. This is the wall that we had before. This is the new wall that I want to create. So this is 12.7 here. After this layer, we have polyethylene, which is just going to be a different layer. So if I change this to my poly ethylene vapor barrier, it seems that nothing happened now, but when I change the thick, you see that the thickness is more, so it's gonna show in my detail that this is actually vapor barrier. I'm gonna kind of go with thin lines here. Next we have the lumbers. This is 2x6s. What we had before, that was also 2x6, and this is every 12 inches or 304. I want to go with one of 2x6s that I already had here. So I'm gonna go with CO, copy this over here. This is not changing. I'm gonna send the hash. Actually, I want to also copy these two lines over there. Okay, but this time the only difference is that it's gonna actually be every 304 millimeters, so that's gonna be a little bit different in our plan. So if this is the first one in our plan, this is inside, that is inside, that is a section, this is the plan. The next one should be 304 millimeters away, right? So you see they are now closer to each other. That 304 is basically, this is 12 inches center by center. Everything else is the same here, 2x6s. After that, we have the sheathing. And then we have polyester, and the sheathing is 11 millimeters. Okay, so it's gonna be 11 millimeters over there. I can copy this line here and offset this by 11. After that, we have extruded polyester, 25 millimeters. Okay, so I want to offset this by 25, offset this by 25. After that, we have the siding. How about I go with wood siding? Maybe I want to have kind of the same look here. I want to change this to 0.14. That's still 3.85. I want to change this to 3.85. My nominal does not change. Okay, so I want to go with 13 millimeter of wood. So this is going to be offset by 13 on that side, and over here I'm going to move everything a bit further here. So the stud that you see here or at the top is basically a horizontal one. We usually have horizontal studs, one at the top and one at the bottom. So I want to copy this stud, put one at the bottom. So I can switch to my hatch layer. I want a hatch to be here and here. Also, I want a hatch to be here. And if I put one of these here, I also want a hatch over there. And this time I want to go with that other hatch that we had. Or I can actually, that was cellulose, I can go with a new layer. This is gonna be extruded polystyrene, XPS. I wanna go with XPS here. I'm gonna change the color. Now I want to have a hatch here and here. This is my polystyrene layer. I have a hatch here. So now we have all the layers. It seems good. Then we can just add annotations. So I added some dimensions and annotations here. As you see in this one, the insulation is only in between the studs. But in this new one, which has continuous insulation, there is an additional insulation which is continuous. There is no framing in between. And this is how it looks like. Let's do one more example. Let's say if you want to work on package A3, you see this time for RSI we have 3.28, for nominal we have 2.46 plus 132. So I want to actually use the same detail, but I want to change it in a way that is going to kind of provide these values. First, for the nominal insulation, we need 1.32. So 1.32, and we know that the RSI is 0.035 per 1 millimeter. So if I divide that number by this number, I'm going to get the thickness, which is 37.7. So I'm going to go with 38 millimeters. 38 millimeters is going to give me 1.32. So that is now good. So this is 2.46. That means this nominal should be 2.46. That means I can save a lot on this wall because now it's way more than it needs to be. The nominal is 3.87. We want to reduce it to 2.46. So I want to go to the tables. I want to go with the walls. And here, if I go to table WA1, 2.46 is here. I can go, for instance, every 16 inches, that's going to be 1.62. If I put 1.62 here, and this is now 2.46, that's our nominal over there. And 2.46 is R14, so I'm going to change this to R14. In metric, it's 2.46. In imperial, it's 14. And now I'm going with 2x4s, which is actually 38 by 89. So I'm going with 38 by 89. I'm reading the values from table WA1. So I can add WA1 here. For this other table, we were using WA2 actually. So this is going to be 2 by 4s. And this is 38 by 89. Now this is 3.39, which is good. If I need to go with every 12 inches, I can do that too. So I can go every 12 inches. This is going to be 1.59. This is still 2.46. So I want to go with 1.59, 3.36. This is still above 3.28. Now this is every 12 inches, so I need to change this. Okay, so now this is a wall which satisfies a package A3. I just want to check something. If I go back here, I want to change this. This is actually the RSI of the lumber, which is a bit different when I go with 2 by 4s. Okay, now it's better. Now this is 1.32. But the polystyrene is now 38 millimeters in thickness instead of 25, which allows us to reduce kind of the type of the insulation that we have between the cavity fill. So we had 3.87, now we have 2.46. It's 2 by 4 inches, every 12 inches, 1.59, and it adds up to 3.36. So now you see, the nominal insulation that we are providing is actually 2.46 plus 1.3 continuous. So this goes to here. Excuse me. Here. And for effective, this 3.36, I can put it here, 3.36. So again, we are meeting the code for nominal and we are exceeding the code for effective RSI.